How can I increase the swap? How can I know how much swap is used? How much more I need? So those things I can learn in swap administration. Right? And various things can happen in the system. Right? So I have about 5,000 machines, and I can't go and check each and every machine when there is something wrong happening. So I want all these error messages to point to a system where I am, where I'm always, right? Or I want this to be distributed to some users or some other people in the office, right? So if there's error message, it should go to a file, or it go to a person, another person, or it comes to me, right? Then somebody will know, or there is an error. For that, I have to know how to manage log facility. So if this happens, this is the action which will be taken. So there is a file called syslog.conf that will be read by syslogd daemon. So it has two main columns, one is selector, other one is action. So this selector, this action. So we'll learn about that. So selector has two fields, right? Facility and the level, and then we have action. So that's what we have to put it in that file. So we'll learn about this. Okay? And also I have to share these file systems, data. How can people access data? So I should know how to distribute file systems. So I will learn how to distribute file systems over the network. Okay. These are all required in a work environment, right? So that's why I'm trying to relate to the real thing which happens in a work environment to what you are going to learn. So if you know all these things, then you can perform your job as an administrator. You can apply this knowledge to any Unix flavor, right? That's how we taught you, right? But the problem is, the job, the administrator's job is keeping on increasing. Administrator doesn't have rest time. We can't hire more and more administrator because they are expensive. So what can we do? Any solution? Administrator cannot do all this. Most of our work is done by administrator. So what can we do now? Can we create some roles? So we have to learn about creating roles. Role-based access control. We give access to restricted functions based on the role a user is suing to, right? If I am a regular user, I am going to sue as a backup guy, then I will have the power to backup. But when I exit, I lose the power. Something like that I want. So I don't have to disturb a super user, right? So we have to know how to create roles. In AX also we have roles. In HP Unix we have roles, right? Yeah. When you talk about roles, there are few files. Apart from your etc password, apart from your etc shadow, etc group, there are a lot of other files. Call etc US user attr, user attr, user underscore attr. And you have etc security and a directory security, there are some files, execor, etc, like that. I have just write some files. These are the files which you have to learn. User, att, and then etc security, right? There's a file called auth, attr, prof, attr, underscore attr. And then there is another file called exec underscore attr. So we have to learn about how to modify these files. We can modify these files using text, but it's very difficult. If we are modifying these files with text, because these are so many columns with text editor, it's very difficult, right? Because I have about maybe 20 columns, maybe, right? Some columns are there, for future use. Some columns are used, some columns are for future use. So if I put my information in the wrong place, it may not work, right? So I should know where to put. So it's very difficult for me, very difficult for me. So I need a graphical utility for that purpose. So I have to learn about a graphical utility called SMC, Solaris Management Console, not only for this purpose, for the purpose of creating rates. I should know how to create rate. I use SMC to create rate, or I use meta commands to create rates. I should know both. Some people like to use meta commands to create rate, or some people like maybe SMC to create rate. Right? So what application am I using? Even though I use SMC, something should be running, right? That is called Solaris Volume Management. So I should learn about Solaris Volume Management. This was introduced in Solaris version 8. In Solaris 7, they were using Solstice Disk Suite, but in 8, they introduced this. They were using in 8 and 9, right? Some companies use Veritas, and some companies, this is free with the system, so they use this, right? If they don't have to do very complicated functionalities in volume management, okay? Not only this, people have to print. That is an important issue in the company. They have to print. You get a lot of issues there, right? So we have to learn how to manage printing, print subsystem or print environment. We will know how to create printer, how to manage printer, how to delete printer, how to create a print job manually, how to watch all the print jobs, how to promote your friend's print job up, right? All those things we should know. So we learn how to promote a job up, demote a job, or hold a job, okay? All those things we learn. And how to move a job from one printer to another printer, this printer got spoiled. So I have to move the job from this printer to another printer, right? And I have to tell the people, oh, this printer is not working, so collect your print job from that printer, from that room. So I have to learn how to do all those things. So those we learn in printer management. Okay? We talked about file system permissions. We learned a little file system permissions, and we set file system permissions using chmod, right? Chmod is not always enough for us. So we had to learn about another method to set permissions. That method is called setFFL. So the advantage of this command is, you learned about setFFL from Linux. Yeah, so you learned that. So you will do something like that here also. Are you very clear when you learn that?
Yeah.
If it is very clear, then we will make it short, right? Mm-hmm. If it is not clear, we will make it long. Mm-hmm. That, what is the advantage of setting ACLs? What is the advantage?
It will give particular user permission.
We don't have to give the entire group.
Particular.
Yeah, in a group, maybe one person, two person, I can give more permission or less permission. Same with the group, right? I can do that, right? And I can, like, if a file is created by me, only myself and my primary group members will have permission. But I can give permission to others by using this, right? So these are the advantages. And also, when we talk about permissions, we will also talk about set UID, sticky bit, and then what? Set GID. You already know about set GID.
Yeah.
What is the advantage of set UID? If a person is executing a command where set UID is set, right? The person will get the power of the owner of that command for that particular execution. Set UID, right? So you learn about those things in detail, but you have learned few of those things before, but we will learn again, right? Nothing wrong in learning again.
We will practice a little bit more.
And also, like when the survey is working, people will start sending complaints to me, right? Can you avoid complaints?
No.
You can. You can avoid complaints by taking action before the complaint comes to you. So I have to do certain activities in the system. So what are the activities I should do? I have to check my logs, right? All the log files, whether there is anything coming to happen, or I can check the processes, right?
Right.
And how the file system are getting filled up, right? So I have to monitor, monitoring the system. For space problem, for process problems, right? What else? You can check your logs. You can check the command using prstat or ps, all those things. Right, log files and the size of hard drive by using df. So all those we will learn. Most of them you know already, right? Some of them you don't know, right? And sometimes the user will say, my solar system is very slow. One guy is saying, my solar system is very slow. He's a very beginner for IT. He doesn't know IT. So how can you identify his system? Mm-hmm. You are in another building, he is in another building. How will you identify what is the name of the system he is using? He doesn't know. He doesn't know how to go to command prompt. He's going to waste time. You know that? You can type R users minus A. So networking related commands and these type of commands are useful. Right. So we will talk about networking here, right? How to set up networks, how to see the users in the network, how to see the computers in the network, right? If a person complains, how to find out which computer is calling from, right? So we will learn about little OSI layers also, little, right? You will learn about OSI layer in detail in your Cisco course, right? But here, CCNA, you can learn more OSI, but here, introduction to OSI, right? All of you must be knowing OSI, right? You know? Everybody in the networking field, they should know, right?
Seven
for
layers.
But anyway, we'll do that, don't worry, huh?
Seven layers,
yeah.
OSI, seven layers. I've seen it before.
Seen it before, but we'll help you. I will teach in a different way, right? A simpler way, right?
If I see the structure, I'll remember it.
But you don't have to remember that way, the way you all are telling, so not like that. OSLA is a different approach. I will teach in a different approach, right? So you will understand why you should know that, right? But it's not like seven layers, or these are the layers, memorizing, not like that. Right? So we talk about networking. Yeah, we talk about networking, right? And then we will talk about OSI layers, and then RCP, all those things will come under this. Okay? And also we will talk about packages, right? Yesterday I forgot to write packages, right? We talk about packages because sometimes I have installed programs, right? So package administration. And also patch administration.
Package means
patch
different.
What is that?
Patch.
Mm-hmm.
Patch is what?
Okay.
Package means software. Fix.
Package is a software. Patch is also software. Fix. Patch is made up of package also, right? So, but purpose of package is to install an application, to install a driver. I have to add a package. Patch is there is a problem in the system, or there is an enhancement for the system, or there is a virus solution for the system. The definition for a patch is a program which replaces the existing program that prevents the normal functioning of the system. If I have have something in the system which is preventing the normal functioning of the system, I replace this.
Dependence.
Say for example, your car, your tire is making noise. So this is not, it's not allowing the normal functioning of the car. So you replace that.
It's,
so that is a patch. You bought a nice stereo, nice GPS for the car. That is like a package.
It's
that is not.
Update, right?
It's like an update for this purpose. Is preventing the normal functioning of the system, or it enhances the function of the system.
Or maybe allow more functionality or different approach.
Those are
upgrading the versions.
Pardon?
It's like upgrading the versions or something.
No, not version. Mm-hmm. Upgrading, not upgrading, enhancing. You can't say upgrading, enhancing, right? Okay, then sometimes I went to the system, like Spark system. Spark system has about 3 hard drives. I have installed Solaris in 3 different ways in all these 3 hard drives. Then my company is not big. As and when is required, I boot from different hard drive. So I get a different environment, right? Different ways I have installed in 3 hard drives. So I get a different environment. Night shift this environment, day shift this environment, for example. So before I go to the Solaris operating system, I wanted to decide, I wanted to tell the system, boot from this hard drive, boot from this hard drive. How can I tell? Before I go to the operating system. Operating system is not running. For that, I should know something called open boot prompt. Open boot prompt. Before Solaris starts, it goes to open boot prompt. Then from open boot ROM, it goes to Solaris, right? So in open boot ROM, I can tell the system, boot from second hard drive, boot from network, boot from something tape, something like that, right? So that is what we learn in this program. So is Solaris operating system running here? Okay, prompt. Is Solaris operating system running? Here we see only okay prompt. Is Solaris operating system running here? No Solaris operating system. It's running an interpreter called fourth language. Fourth is the person who discovered fourth language. So that interpreter tells, okay, I will say print environment boot minus device, boot device. Then it will show disk one, then disk two, then network. So it gives the print environment. If I say set environment, auto boot true, auto boot question mark true, then it will automatically boot to Solaris, it won't go to open boot prompt. If I say set environment, auto boot question mark false, then it won't go to Solaris, it will go to open boot prompt, then from there I have to say boot. So those type of things can be done. Right? Sometimes in my environment, when the server went down, when it reboots, I don't want it to go to Solaris operating system. So I can tell auto boot is false. Then it won't go to Solaris. It will be in the open boot prompt. Right?
One question.
Yeah.
In the maintenance mode, is the same when it prompts to see that the open boot prompt, or is it different from the maintenance mode?
Maintenance mode, you are talking about AX maintenance mode. That is different, right? Here maintenance mode means run level S or run level 1.
Okay.